Hey everyone, welcome you all. In the today's video, let us see how we can find mandatory fields in a web page. So let me show an example here. So this is my registration account form. In this, if you look at, there are multiple fields are there, like a first name, last name, email, password, and so on. And basically we can easily say these are all mandatory fields by looking at the star mark, right? But through automation, how we can find them, they are mandatory or not. So to see that, let me inspect this one of the element, first name, and basically it is a label element, right? And if I look at this, there is a star mark is on the page, but that is not displayed on this DOM here, right? Because the star is basically here is a pseudo element. Okay, pseudo elements are basically, they are hidden elements. There are hidden elements and they can use as part of CSS, they can use to apply some kind of a styles on the web element. So to decide whether this element is, or to check this element is mandatory field or not, we need to first check the star mark present or not. For that, we need to capture the star mark from this element, right? Then only we can decide this is a mandatory field. But if I look at here HTML, you don't see the star mark. Instead of something, you can see before. So that is actually representing a pseudo element. Okay, so first let us understand what is pseudo element. So pseudo elements are abstract elements in the CSS. Means what? On the UI, we are able to see this star, but in the DOM, we are not able to see that. There's abstract elements. And it allows you to style a specific parts of an element without adding an extra HTML. So if I look at this, for the star mark, there is no HTML added. For the label, for input box, there are multiple HTML tags are there, but except the star, there is no HTML is present. So it is allows you to style specific parts of an element without adding any extra HTML. So these are some examples of pseudo element, like first line, selection, before, after, has. Most of the times, so these pseudo elements start with colon, colon. Okay, that is representing a pseudo element. So the challenging thing is how we can capture the star, how we can capture this pseudo element. So once you are able to capture this, we can check whether this is, we can decide whether it is a mandatory element or not, or mandatory field or not. So through automation, how we can achieve this? So we can achieve this through JavaScript executor. So we can execute some piece of code or some script through JavaScript executor. Then we can capture the star mark, which is basically representing a pseudo element. Now, let me show you how we can capture. Sometimes the star will be after the label or before the label. So it depends on the element. So for example, if here the star is displayed before the label. So if you look at HTML here, there is a before is there. Suppose sometimes the star is present after the label. Then here you can see after. So it depends on the type of the pseudo element. You can see the keyword here. So there are multiple pseudo element keywords. So first line, selection, before, after, has, and something like. For example, selection. So this will be used most of the time to select elements, something, some text we are going to select. For example, I want to select like this, or I want to select like this. So this can be happened through selection. Has means some element is having some kind of a content inbuilt. So that is also placed by using hash and so on. So these are different type of pseudo elements. Right, so let's see how we can capture this star for every field or every element, every label which is present in the registration account form. So for that, we need to use JavaScript executor. But before that, let us try to capture this label and get the text. And that text contains the star or not. Okay, we will check it. Because sometimes in some web pages, you don't see the star as a pseudo element. You will get the star along with the text element. Get text, once you capture the get text of this label, you will be able to get the star in some web pages, but they are not pseudo elements. Okay. Now let's see, first capture the get text, and then if star is not available, then we will capture the star using JavaScript executor. So let's go to my project, Selenium Java Ticks and Tricks. And here, my test already created a new package. Now inside this, I'm creating a new class. I'll name it as a finding mandatory fields. Basically, we are trying to use a pseudo element identification concept. Okay, so pseudo elements. All right, so let me take this main method. And here, first of all, we need to create a web driver instance. I'm just creating web driver and driver equal to new Chrome driver. So you can use any browser. So I'm trying to use a Chrome browser here. Okay, so now just import this web driver and Chrome driver. Now I'm launching my page directly. I can say driver.get, and here place your application URL. I'm just capture the direct URL registration page and just providing here. And then I'll try to maximize the page. I say driver.manage.window.maximize. Okay, right. So now let us first capture all the fields, all the label elements from this form. So if I look at this DOM again, this is basically a form, right? So let's go to the form. From there, we will capture all the labels. So inside the form, every label, every field is having some label tag here. So to capture only the first name, last name, email, password, subscribe, these are labels. So I'm writing the six path. When I say label, six elements are matching. Along with this input field, there is a newsletter and there is a message. I have read and agree the privacy policy. This is also a field. Let me just capture this XPath and capture all the labels. So I say driver.findElements by.XPath. So now I'm just capturing all the elements and keep them inside the variable. So I'll say elements. This is basically a list of web elements. Right, so now import this list and then import this web element. Right, now I captured all the elements. Now let us try to capture the text of the every element, and we will see whether we are able to capturing the star or not. So for that, I'm directly writing a loop here from the all the elements. I'm reading each and every element. This is basically a web element. Right, so from this web element, I'm trying to capture the text and then I'm trying to print this element.getText. Okay, now let me try to execute and we'll see whether it is capturing all the labels or not. So my page is successfully launched and it has captured everything. Now if I go back and see, you got all the things, right? All the labels we captured, but it is not giving the star. So it is not giving the star because the star is not appeared inside this HTML DOM. So we are not able to capture that star. So if you are able to capture the star, based on that, we can decide whether it is mandatory field or not, right? So that is our target. So this is not able to give stars. So we cannot decide whether it's a mandatory field or not. So now the next thing is, from each element, we need to capture the star mark. Okay, instead of getting the text, we need to capture the star mark from each element. So that is possible using JavaScript executor. So what I'll do is I will first create a JavaScript executor. So before starting the loop, I create a JavaScript executor. And through this, I can execute JavaScript, right? So let me take this JS. Let me comment this text for now. So JS dot execute script. So to capture the Pseudo element content, the content of the Pseudo element, we need to pass the element first. Okay, so as a second parameter, we need to pass whichever element we want to capture the content of the Pseudo element, that element we have to pass here. Now, how we can extract that Pseudo content from that element? So we need to write a piece of code here. So JavaScript code I want to execute. Let me put the JavaScript code here. In the double quotes, I say return window dot get computed style. Okay, get computed style. And in this, we need to pass an argument. So this element we have to take inside this method. So for that, we need to use an array called arguments of zero, which is actually capturing this element into this array, arguments of zero, comma. In the single quote, we need to specify the Pseudo element text. So what is a Pseudo element text here is before. Sometimes you can see star mark after the label, then you can see here after. So it depends on that, you need to specify here. In the single quote, colon, colon. So I say before. Okay, and say quotes closed and bracket is also closed. And after that, here we need to call one more method dot get property value, get the property value. So which property value we need to capture is content. So that you can put in the single quote, I say content. So this whole code or script will actually capture the content of the pseudo element, content of the pseudo element. So this is the whole thing. So it seems very bigger, right? So what I'll do is I'll remove from here. I will store in a string variable. I'm just keeping a string script equal to, right? So, and then I will pass this particular script here inside the JavaScript executor along with the element. So what this will return is, it will basically return the pseudo element content in the form of an object. So we need to convert it into string. So I say dot to string method I'm calling. So now we will get that pseudo content, pseudo of element in the form of string. I say content. So what is this content? Is basically a string only. Okay. So once you capture this, this is actually gives us a star mark. Okay. Let us try to print and see. Okay. So before checking, I'm just printing the content. So earlier when you print the text element of a text of the element, it is just printed only labels. We are not getting the star marks. But this time by using JavaScript executor, I have executed some piece of script, capture that element content and printing the content. So whatever the mandatory fields are there, it will capture the star or content of the pseudo element for every field. Let me run and see. So it is launching my page, maximizing the page. Now we can just go back and see. See now, whatever elements are having star mark, which is captured, but some of the element doesn't have a star mark. So it is returning none, right? If I look at this page, so if I look at this subscribe and this one, these two elements are not having star marks. Only these four elements are having star mark. So we are successfully able to capture the pseudo element content. So now based on this, we can decide which one is a pseudo element, which one is a not. Which one is a mandatory field, which one is a not mandatory field, right? So we capture the content of the pseudo element of every element. Now, instead of printing this, so what I'll do is I will put one condition here. So what is that condition? If this content dot contains, okay, dot contains a star. So then what we can say, that element is a mandatory field, or that field is a mandatory field. Here I will put, so which element, how we will capture the element. So I'm also printing, instead of just printing this, print element is a mandatory field. I can say mandatory, right? So mandatory field. Okay. So if not, suppose if doesn't have a star, so then I can say else, it is not mandatory. Not mandatory field. But if you want to write a more clear message, which one is mandatory field, which one is not mandatory field, we're anyway capturing the text of this element, right? Try to put that also here and concatenate. So that it will just gives you which element is mandatory, which element is not mandatory very clearly. So here I'm just trying to remove this content. Right. So what we have done here is we have captured each and element, each and every element. And from that, we are extracted the pseudo content using JavaScript executor. And if the content is having star, it is a mandatory field. If it is not having, not a mandatory field. So this is how we can do this. So now after that, I will try to quit from my browser. I can say driver.quit. So let's execute now. So we can handle pseudo elements using JavaScript executors. Now we can just look at this. So these are the mandatory fields. First four are the mandatory fields and rest of them are not mandatory fields. Okay. So this is how we can capture the content of the pseudo element. Sometimes you can see the star mark after the label. So in that case, instead of before, you can see after. So that you need to specify inside the script here. Okay. And rest of the things are exactly the similar. So this is how we can handle pseudo elements. And with that, we can also find what are the mandatory fields present in the particular form, right? So that's all for this video. Thanks for watching.